In this example, we are given that in the circuit shown in figure, we are required to find the charge on capacitor as a function of time t. If at t equal to 0, the switch is closed. Now, in this situation, if we close down the switch at t equals to 0, obviously a current flows in this loop, another in this loop, and after analyzing the circuit, we need to calculate the charge deposited on capacitor as a function of time. And I feel the simplest way out is by removal of capacitor across the terminals A and B. We transform the remaining circuit in form of the equivalent Thevenin's battery and its internal resistance. So if we just redraw the circuit, it will look like this, in which there is 18 volt battery, there is a 5 ohm resistance, there is another 1 ohm resistance, after closing the switch it is connected, there is a 3 ohm resistance, and here another 3 ohm resistance, and A and B terminals are now considered open, as here we have removed the capacitor. Now in this situation, if we consider the equivalent resistance across terminals A and B, then we can see that if this 18 volt battery is considered to be ideal, here 5 ohm is connected in series with this 1 ohm resistance, which is effectively 6 ohms. And the 6 ohm resistance is in parallel with this 3 ohm resistance. So this RAB can be written as 6 ohm in parallel with 3 ohm resistance. And this group is in series is a combination with this 3 ohm resistance. So in this situation, if we just analyze, this RAB can be written as 6 into 3 by 6 plus 3, that is 18 by 9, it is 2 ohm resistance plus 3 ohm resistance. So, the internal resistance of the circuit we can write as 5 ohm. And if we wish to calculate the open circuit potential difference across terminals A and B, here we circulate a current I in this loop, and this loop is open, so no current will flow here. So, in this situation, if we write KVL equation for I, if we start from this point, we can say it will be plus 18 minus 5i minus 3i minus I is equals to 0. So this can be written as 9i is equals to 18. This implies the value of current in the circuit in this loop of the circuit is equals to 2 ampere. And using this current, we can find out the potential difference across AB. If we again write KVL equation from A to B, here you can see this can be written as VA, and no potential drop across this 3 ohm because no current is flowing here. So if we move in this direction, it will be minus 3i, I is 2 ampere. This can be written as VB. This implies here we can see VA minus VB we are getting is 6 volt. Now we can redraw the circuit across terminals A and B. The circuit can be written as an equivalent internal resistance of 5 ohm in series with the open circuit EMF across A and B, that is 6 volt, with the A is at high potential, B is at low potential, this is the situation, this will be 6 volt. Now in this situation, we can replace the capacitor which we have removed, which is a 4 microfarad capacitance. And in this circuit, when the switch is closed, here we can directly write down the charge on capacitor as a function of time. This can be written as CV 1 minus e to power minus t by RC. So if we substitute the values for the charge, here capacitance is 4 microfarad, V is 6 volts, so this can be written as 24, 1 minus e to power minus t by, here the product of R and C we can write as 20, this will be taken in microseconds, and this will be the result in microcoulomb. So this is the charge on capacitor as a function of time, and this is the answer to this problem.